Welcome to the show on this Friday night, a night that's a lot about high school football. We're going to be focusing first, though, on the NFL and the concern over concussions. Why? Because of what happened last night to Miami Dolphins quarterback Tua Tagovailoa. Fans watched one of the NFL's most promising young quarterbacks get carted off the field on a stretcher and taken to a hospital. Tua suffered a head and neck injury, but he was released from the hospital. And within the last few hours, his coaches said Tua is going to be sidelined from the Dolphins indefinitely after he was slammed to the turf and hit his head twice in 5 days. And the NFL Players Union has launched an investigation to see if protocols, safety protocols, were actually followed when Tua got hit in the game before last night's game. So what are these protocols in the National Football League, and what more should we be doing to prevent these things from happening? Morgan Wolf spoke with a doctor and a retired NFL player to talk perspective.
You saw this last hit. I mean, he was physically contorted.
Thursday night football took a tragic turn as the country watched Tua Tagovailoa take a big hit.
It ended my career.
Something Minnesota's Ben Utek is all too familiar with.
I took my fifth documented concussion in 2009 with the Cincinnati Bengals. Having gone through this to a degree, I first thought about his parents. You know, I'll never forget my parents' reaction.
Outrage from fans and former players on social media.
I watched Tua display concussion-like symptoms last week.
Questioning the NFL's protocol.
That happening so closely to the last injury, this is a big concern. Why was he on the field after the previous diagnosis?
Ben says the NFL has non-biased neurospecialists outside of the team doctors that are at each game. They run players through traumatic brain injury tests and come to decisions independently. Last Sunday, Tua took a hit that made him wobbly when he tried to walk, but he was given the go by those teams to go back into the game. That's the decision that the players' union was already investigating when he took the field for last night's game.
Seeing that is hard to watch.
Something Dr. Ashley Borkland questions.
But we recommend not returning to vigorous activity or any activity until all of your symptoms are gone.
You only have one brain.
Whether you're a 7-year-old or a 30-year-old, this is something that you're going to have for the rest of your life when you have a brain injury. You have to protect that brain, and the brain is more important than the game in the end.
Does it make you think back to your career?
None of the rules that exist today were available when I was playing. There's always an emotional reaction for me when I see other players going through a serious traumatic brain injury on the field, because I understand long-term effects.
Are you, as a player, oftentimes willing to minimize your pain so that you can be a part of your team?
The short answer is yes. There are a lot of pressures that professional athletes face. One of the most intrinsic pressures is wanting to be there for your team and wanting to produce for your team.
Finding life beyond the sport. Something Ben says all players have to learn for themselves.
What makes you special and what makes you full of purpose is not a game. Take into consideration that you have an incredible life ahead of you. And what's most important is that life is full of joy, and it's full of hope, and it's full of health.
Within the last 2 hours, Tua put out a statement on Twitter saying, "I want to thank everyone for their prayers and support," adding that it was difficult to not be able to finish the game and to be there with his teammates. He said, "I am grateful for the support and care I've received from the Dolphins, friends, and family."
I think what's really cool about Ben, Morgan, is he is able to have that perspective after the fact. And we're talking about decisions that happen in the game. And I was talking to Randy Shaver about this earlier. You know, when a player's in that moment, they want to play and they're not thinking 10 years down the road, maybe.
Yeah, I mean, and like same thing with us too. Like we do everything we can here at KARE, like to help our team. It's the same mentality, maybe even just heightened more when you're a professional athlete.
Yeah, well, we wish him the best, and hopefully he gets better and healthy soon. Thanks so much, Morgan.